This chicken liver dish with pomegranate molasses, seven spice, yogurt and flatbread is one of my favorites. It's a Dock Kitchen classic. I had it in Lebanon years ago and kind of brought it back and changed it, and it was just been on the menu ever since. People would come up to the pass and say, I didn't think I liked livers, but that dish was amazing, which was always really kind of heartwarming somehow for me. Nudi is almost always on the menu at Rotorino. It's a brilliant dish. It's been nudi, meaning nude. The pasta, it's like a ravioli without any pasta. So we season the ricotta, and through the year we do different ones, sometimes peas, squash, mint. We season it and then we roll it in semolina, and we let it sit in the semolina until it kind of forms its own skin. And then we poach it, so it makes this incredibly light, delicious ricotta dumpling. I first learned to make it at River Cafe, and then I made it with April Bloomfield at Spotted Pig when I worked there years ago, and I wanted to put it on the menu when I opened at Rotorino. The clay baked duck at Craft in Greenwich was born out of a kind of, you know, my sort of obsession with just Googling weird stuff about cooking. You know, I was looking at kind of ancient British cooking techniques, and clay baking was very important. But if you didn't have an oven, you wanted to cook something that you couldn't just cook directly over the fire, it's a good way to do it. So we developed this way of cooking a duck. It's quite a complex process with a brine, and we make miso out of broad beans that we sort of paint the skin with, which gives an incredible rich texture. And then we bake it wrapped in fermented cabbage and clay, break it open at the table, and people love it. It's been on the menu since we opened. I'm sure it'll be on the menu until we close. I've been obsessed with making cacio e pepe since as long as I can remember. It was a recipe that was in my first cookbook I wrote when I was 24. And when I opened Palatino last January, I really wanted to have it on the menu because it's a classic Roman dish. And it sums up all that is good about Italian food for me, because there's no ingredients. It's just cheese and pepper and pasta. But when you put it together in the right way, it creates something so much more than the sum of its parts. Pastaio is my pasta restaurant that I recently opened in Soho. And obviously we mostly make pasta there. My favorite right now on the menu is the agnoli, and it's a bunch of different wild meats cooked slowly together with juniper and red wine and stuffed inside little pasta parcels. It's great, I love it.